Hola, hola. My name is Ramon, cosmetic formulator and sunscreen fanatic, and today we're continuing on talking about my favorite sunscreens for summer by doing a review and talk through of some combination and mineral-based body sunscreens. So I have a good handful in front of me that I've been trying out, and again, these aren't just completely all mineral options. I do have a couple combination, meaning a mixture of mineral and chemical filters as well. And I'm going to talk about my experience using all of them, and let me just tell you, spoiler alerts, some of them were hits and some of them were busts. Also, make sure you check out my other sunscreen videos I've been uploading over the last month. I've been talking about my favorite sunscreens for any and every skin type. So if you're looking for a sunscreen for your specific needs, I probably have a video where I recommended your next holy grail. So starting out with my least favorites, and again, this is just based off my own personal experience. If you like these, first of all, I want to know why. Like, how do you got them to work, or what scenario it is that these work really well for you? First one I have is actually from my favorite sunscreen brand, and that is from Sunbum. This is their Sunbum Mineral SPF 50 Spray. Mineral sunscreens in themselves for body are, like, in my mind, harder to come by, but in spray form, even more difficult. So if my boyfriend sent me a picture of this, I'm like, I want to try that. And so when I saw mineral, I was really intrigued because one of my favorite face sunscreens, mineral face sunscreens, is their tinted mineral sunscreen. And so similar packaging, similar concept, I was like, let me try it out. The thing with this is that the texture of this on the skin is amazing. It dries down to the most natural semi-matte finish. It looks like your skin. This leaves a very noticeable cast though. And so it's this weird combination of, I see that the area that I sprayed this on or worked it into is substantially fairer than the rest of my body, but it looks really good. It's not like very, very greasy, very, very cakey. It's not like it's collecting in my hair. So it was a very polarizing experience. If you have more fair skin, this could be a banger. And again, I love the texture of this. I love the smell of this. It just did not work on my skin because I love to cast. Looking for a spray sunscreen and you are fair or you do not mind a white cast at all, this is actually a really good product. It just leaves a white cast for me and I don't like that. Next is from a brand called Bare Republic. This is their mineral sunscreen lotion, specifically in the scent Vanilla Cocoa. I hadn't heard of this brand, and I believe my boyfriend found this at either Target or a Kroger brand grocery store. But it is 100% mineral. This is titanium dioxide at 2.9%, zinc oxide at 7.8%. Besides that, there's not a lot going on in the formulation besides some emollient oils. You also have some vanilla in there, which I think helps with the smell of it. This is one of those brands that really hypes up, like, mineral are clean, mineral are natural, and we all know how I feel about that. But this is vegan, cruelty-free, and whatnot, water-resistant as well. This, texture-wise, is rich to me. This comes out as, like, a light paste, and working this into the skin is not the most elegant experience. Working it into my arms and my legs, I feel like I was pulling the skin off of it. Eventually, did I get it, like, worked into my skin? Kind of, but I still noticed there was like a pigment suspended on my skin. I feel like it wasn't working into my skin very, very well. It's a more moisturizing texture for sure. It just left a white cast on me and it was a little bit too rich in terms of like the texture. Like it was hard to work into my skin. So user experience wasn't the best. Also the smell to me smells like, in Seattle, there was this like vegan ice cream place that had like very vegan ice cream flavors. They were not good at all. This smelled the way that the vanilla ice cream from them tasted, in that it was trying to be vanilla ice cream, but it was like someone who had lost their taste trying to remember what vanilla tasted like. If that makes any sense. So I did not enjoy the sensory of this one at all either. And then last one is a sunscreen stick from Neutrogena. This is their Neutrogena Sheer Zinc Mineral Sunscreen Stick SPF 50 Plus, water resistant with vitamin E. This looks like you're putting on a very thick powdery deodorant. It's a very odd experience. In terms of how this works into the skin, it kind of doesn't. This goes on, you try to work it in, and I feel like it just spreads out the white chalkiness and it sets a little bit more matte, but it's not very matte. It's just like it gets harder to start moving around because it's like setting down. I tried to explain. It's not my favorite. On the body, it's like not the worst actually in terms of working into like my like legs, which have more hair on them. But on the face, I tried this on my face. It was just very white, very, very pasty, very, very chalky. Did not enjoy the experience. This is one that might be good for people that have very sensitive skin and they just need to use a mineral sunscreen, or if you're very fair and you don't mind. But this does have 21.6% zinc oxide, so you're just getting a very high concentration of it, plus that higher SPF value. It's never a good combination most times, so. But let's just talk about some of my favorite options. And these are the ones that actually like didn't work badly. I would consider picking these up, or they're ones that I actually do use on my body if I need to for different reasons. Some of these are a combination, but I do have one sole mineral option, so stick around for that one. First ones we're gonna start off with for those are these ones from Altruist. Altruist is a EU-based brand. They are dermatologist and skin surgeon like formulated. Very notorious for their super high SPF and UVA protection values, for being super water resistant, but being really elegant textures and being very affordable. This one is £4.50. This one is £4. Starting with this one, on. This is SPF 30. This specifically has a UVA PF of 39, so super good protection. And at the SPF 30, I consider this more like a daily wear sunscreen. Well, this is super elegant. Works into the skin beautifully, super lightweight. This is combination in terms of filters. I'm breaking that down for you. This has octosalates, avobenzone, octocrylene, insulazol, nano titanium dioxide, and then nano tinosorb A2B. That is a hybrid filter. It's a chemical filter that functions very similarly to a mineral filter. It's insoluble, it's suspended in formulation, and it does also reflect a small amount of light that hits it. These are formulated to be great for sensitive skin types as well. Super elegant, works into the skin beautifully, really nice for reapplication, really good sweat resistant. So if you're working out, going swimming, beautiful texture, beautiful wear, and again, £4.50 for 200 ml. And then next I have the SPF 50 of it. One thing worth noting, size difference is considerable, and I don't necessarily want to put this out there as like the best for like body necessarily. But a lot of the same attributes that the SPF 30 has, the SPF 50 also has. It just has higher protection value, but it's just half the size for a little bit less money. So it's one thing worth noting is you're not going to get a lot of product out of it. If you like the texture of the 30 and you want just higher protection value, this is also worth noting. And also when you think about it, this is £4 for 100 ml. Most commercial sunscreens are 50 ml, and that's what, $2 per 50 ml. So it's in itself also very affordable. So it's not a bad option. It's just, it's smaller packaging. And I think the SPF 30 does a good enough job. Next is the Sun Guard from Jack Black, SPF 45, broad spectrum water resistant. This is combination. This one has octinoxalate 7.5%, octosalate 3%, and zinc oxide at 8%. This is an amazing option. I love this on the face. It's a really good, elegant texture. This goes on white and it's a little bit concerning at first, but when you work it in, eventually it sets down very elegantly, very beautifully on the skin. A natural to a satin finish, and it is a very elegant wear. Love this on the face, and therefore it translates really nicely to the body. This is also, I think, $16 for 4 fluid ounces, so you're getting a good amount of product out of this as well. So definitely a good option as well if you don't mind combination sunscreen and you might just want one sunscreen that you could use on both your face and your body and just be good. And next is one from Blue Lizard. This is technically an Australian brand, although I believe these are American made. And then this specifically is their active mineral based sunscreen, but notes, it says mineral based. Zinc oxide at 10%, titanium dioxide at 5.36%, but also has octosalate, which is a chemical filter. This is a combination sunscreen. SPF 50 plus, broad spectrum, water resistant for 80 minutes. Blue Lizard's a really fun brand. I'm just starting to get into their sunscreens now after getting a lot of recommendations for them. So I do have a few more I'm trying out. There's one more I want to talk about in this video though. And the hype around them is that, you know, they do a lot of the like safe, natural things that mineral sunscreens are like glorified for, when in reality it's a lot of pseudoscience. But they're also known for their packaging. So what the packaging does is that it changes color when exposed to UV light, so that you are aware I'm in UV exposure, like ample UV exposure. I should be diligent with my sunscreen application and reapplication. Specifically with this one, again, combo sunscreen, this gives me a lot of the teas of the Bare Natural one that I didn't like, but just it has a lot of better qualities to it. This does take a minute to work into the skin, but it's actually not a horrible experience once you've worked it in enough and let it sit down enough. This also, I think, is just a better sensory experience. It doesn't have a smell that it's supposed to have. It doesn't match. Like, it smells like a sunscreen, but I know it's gonna smell like a sunscreen. Also, very affordable, very accessible. My boyfriend bought this at Target, and I know some of the other Blue Lizard sunscreens I bought very easily on iHerb, so I'll have all the links for these obviously in the description box. But yeah, good option. I really enjoyed this one. So Blue Lizard, so far, it's very intriguing to me. But on a very similar note, I have this one from Blue Lizard, and this is an only mineral sunscreen, and I think it's arguably the most elegant mineral-based body sunscreen I've tried thus far. This is their Blue Lizard SPF 30 Plus Sensitive Mineral Sunscreen. So no SPF 30 plus. This has a lower percentage of the filter. It's a little bit more elegant. So that is one thing worth noting. Generally, the higher the SPF value for a mineral sunscreen, the least elegant it's going to be. And that's like a very sad reality. But if you're taking other very adequate sun protection measures and constantly reapplying when needed, SPF 30 is good. It's adequate to me, especially when it's more heavy duty water resistant, because I know it's going to stay on and do the job it needs to do. But breaking this down, it has 5% titanium dioxide, 10% zinc oxide. Not much else going on with it. This one's water resistant for only 40 minutes. But this one just works in so easy. It's a much more lightweight texture than the tube one. You have to work into your skin a little bit, but this worked into like body hair easily, worked into my skin very nicely, sits down in a more natural to radiant finish. But overall, if you're looking for a more sensitive, skin-friendly sunscreen, and you're semi-melanated like I am, really surprised by how nice this one was. I will try to find and see if I can find a deeper skin individual trying this out as well, just because I wanna know if like someone with a little bit more of a deep complexion will enjoy this. This is the one mineral only body sunscreen that I will say is remote recommended. And with that, that is my review of some mineral and combination filter body sunscreens. But let me know down below what some of your favorite body sunscreens are that are mineral based or combination based that maybe I haven't tried or you find work really good, especially if you have deeper skin. Make sure you hit the subscribe button, notification bell, so that you know when I post more skincare, sunscreen, and Fenty related content on my channel. Give this video a thumbs up, and thanks for watching, guys. Bye.